Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's David, and today I'm going to be reviewing the perfect battery for our camper van. If you are new to the channel and new to solar, I've developed a simple solar guide that is perfect for beginners or anyone who's going to be installing a solar system in their camper van, their RV, their trailer, their boat for the first time. It covers everything from schematics to what each component does. It has a price list with discount codes and a ton of other useful information like tips and tricks during your install. It'll be linked in the description below, so be sure to check that out. All right, let's bring out the king of batteries.
Oh my god, this is so heavy.
Whew. This is the Renogy REGO 400 amp hour self-heating Bluetooth battery, and it is enormous. Regular price on this thing is $3,500. Don't forget to use the discount code made to travel. If you're buying anything from Renogy, you'll get an extra discount. This is a lot of power, and this is gonna be perfect for anyone who has water heaters, electric stovetops, microwaves, things like that. You're gonna need a lot of power, and this is gonna be perfect for us because we have a water heater, and me and Kaylee spend a ton of time like editing content in our vans. So this is gonna be peace of mind, and the best part is it's heated. Right now, it is the end of October, and we actually just got 6 inches of snow up here in Canada, and it's getting cold. This arrived perfect time. I can't wait to install it in our system. Now, a lot of you are probably looking at this cord thinking, what is this? This is the Anderson connection. Renogy designed this REGO setup to be super easy for anyone to install. Instead of having to buy lugs, crimping tools, even cables, now all the products come with everything you need to just be able to plug everything in and get going, which makes it super easy. I obviously don't have a REGO setup, if you guys have watched some of my other videos, and I am going to be looking into how I can get around this. I know I could just take off this Anderson cable and probably install my own cables. As you can see on this battery, it comes with about 1.5 to 2 feet of 4-aught cable here. That's gonna be rated for the max discharge of this battery. The battery also comes with Bluetooth, so you can wirelessly hook up to it through Renogy's app, which I'm not a huge fan of, but it has gotten better over the last year or so. The cells in this battery are rated for 6,000 cycles at 80% DOD, which is pretty good when you're looking at comparing other batteries. Another really great part of this battery is when you're investing this much money, you want it to stay safe. So it is actually inside an aluminum case, which is part of why it's probably so heavy. This battery is IP65 water resistant and also dust and vibration resistant. Renogy has definitely put a lot of extra care into making sure this shell protects the cells and the BMS inside of it. Speaking of weight, this battery actually weighs in at 113 pounds, which is probably the worst part because I'm a pretty big guy, and lugging this thing around was honestly hard to do. If you're a smaller person or you can't carry that much weight, going with a battery like this is gonna be challenging if you have to like take it in and out of your solar system. I plan on just installing this and keeping it as my primary battery all winter, and I'm gonna be doing another follow-up review in the spring to let you guys know how it went. So be sure to subscribe to the channel for when that video comes out. I would honestly recommend 2 people carrying this battery if you can. If it's just you and you're solo, be careful picking this thing up because you could twist the wrong way and really throw your back out. The battery itself has a control panel on here. It has an on-off switch where you can turn the battery on or off to put it into shelf mode or active mode, like some of Renogy's other batteries. So it shows the battery status. You can also turn the heater on and off through this button by holding it for 8 seconds. It'll go into a mode and the heater status will illuminate. You can switch it from red to green to turn the heater on and off. I'd recommend just keeping that on all the time because you always want to keep yourselves safe, but the BMS will also protect the cells for low and high temperature. Underneath the power button here, there's also a battery level with 4 bars. On the end here, it has 2 CAN communication ports, which you can use to hook up to other Renogy REGO products or even the Renogy One, which I also have a review for. If you haven't heard of the Renogy One controller, I have mixed feelings about it, to be honest. I wouldn't recommend it for everyone. I think certain people really enjoy it, but I don't think it's a necessity to have in your solar system. These can also connect to solar controllers, DC to DC controllers. For those of you like me who want to buy this battery, but don't want to buy all the other REGO components just to use these fittings, because I'm already set up for my system pretty well and I don't want to go altering everything, you can actually remove this Anderson connection. It's pretty easy to do. There's a tab here and all you have to do is push up and then these cables will slide out just like that. And that's what it looks like inside. You could also just slide this guy right over top if you wanted to, but what I kind of plan on doing, honestly, is either cutting this cable and installing a lug to attach to my battery disconnect, or another option would be to drill a 3/8 hole right through this flat part and then be able to insert that onto the lug. That is something that you could consider doing. And then that way, if you end up drilling the hole through here, you could always reattach these in the future if you want to use the Anderson connections. That's probably what I'm gonna end up doing. If you cut the wire, you could always splice the wire back together, but splicing 4/0 cable isn't the funnest thing to do. So just something to consider. Even though you don't have the whole REGO setup, you still could go ahead and buy this battery and install it in your solar system and then just adapt these cables. And to be honest, it's nice that it comes with cables, because even copper cables nowadays can be very expensive. So it's nice that this is just part of the package and you don't have to worry about sizing your cable as well, because it's already done for you. And then say in the future, all you have to do, slide that back on just like that and you're good to go. Got the new Renogy 400 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery installed here. You can see it's huge. I had to like shift my inverter up. I think I'm gonna have to do some more tweaking and shift it higher up so this has a little bit more space to breathe. There's barely any room there, but I got it in my system. This is the biggest battery that I've ever tested out. And as I said before, this is gonna be the permanent battery we're using, but I've got it all hooked up. I ended up just modifying the Anderson connector. So basically what I did is I removed the cover and I just ran these directly to my connections. This positive one goes to the battery on off switch, and then the negative goes right down to the shunt, which goes to my 500 amp hour battery monitor. And you can see I have just drilled holes basically through that Anderson connection thing. So I can't use the Anderson connection thing anymore. I was hoping to save that, but obviously that's not going to work, which is fine with me because I don't plan on installing a lot of those REGO components anyways. I just really wanted this battery. And another option I did want to mention is you can actually buy the Anderson connectors that are specifically designed to connect to your bus bars. I didn't want to buy those because it would end up being way too much cable for me. Like, as you can see, my runs are really short. So if I had those Anderson connectors, it would add probably 2 more feet of wire, which I really don't need. And it's important to keep these big wires that are carrying a lot of amps as short as possible to limit the drop. What we can do here is pull out the Renogy app, and I've already hooked it up to Bluetooth. Really easy to do. All you have to do is hit the plus sign in the top corner there, go add device, and then it'll come up. But this is really nice because you can see the battery level, it's at 82, almost 83%. Capacity is 400 amp hours. The present capacity is 330 amp hours. Voltage, present current. I'm charging it at 75 amps. That is solar and shore connection. You can see the heating module status. It was actually really cold this morning, so the heating module status was on when it was quite cold. Got the firmware version, and then you can also see the temperatures there, and then also the cell voltage, so you can see the health. This is so nice to have. So I don't even really need my battery monitor very much anymore. I can just pull this out and see what the battery is actually at. I have our air fryer right here. I'm gonna go ahead and unplug our shore power here. Come back around and fire up this air fryer. This thing draws probably the most wattage, definitely more than our water heater. This will pull about 160 amp. And then I'll just put the phone right here so you can see what we are pulling. All right, so let's hit start. And we are pulling about 150 amps right now. And I have had this kick off in the past with some of my batteries, and I have had cables heat up quite a bit, fuses go. So this will be a really good test for this battery right here to see if everything's working as it should. The air fryer has been running for about 5 minutes and it is working awesome. I'm really impressed with how the battery is handling this. No issues whatsoever. Cables are not heating up at all. No fuses are blowing. It's been working super well. Very happy with it. And I'm definitely excited to continue using this all winter long. Definitely gonna be modifying my plumbing that runs through here just so it's not so close to the electrical. That is gonna be the next job. A little bit of redesign definitely needed for this area after installing this beast of a unit down here. If you guys are interested in this battery, once again, make sure to use that made to travel discount code and you'll get an extra discount when you go to check out. It's a really good price right now. If you guys found this video useful, be sure to like it and subscribe to the channel. I'll be coming out with a lot more content soon. If you have any questions, make sure to leave a comment below and let me know. I'll get back to you as soon as I can, and I'll see you in the next one.